the national chairman of People Democratic Movement, Ibrahim Bashir, has given reason why most Nigerians kick against outright removal of subsidy on premium metal spirit PMS in 2012 when it was initiated by President Goodluck Jonathan. The national chairman said in an interview in Abuja that Nigerians did not trust the then government of using the proceeds of the subsidy removal prudently.
Well, let me tell you the truth. Even I was against the removal of subsidy in 2012. But my views have changed for two fundamental reasons. One, most people that opposed removal of subsidy in 2012 were not opposing the regulation. What they are opposing was that they did not trust the government of the day to use the savings to better their lives. And from the revelations that are coming out of how the treasury was ransacked in the last 5 years, those fears were justified. I was one of those who did not trust the government to use the savings from the removal of subsidy to better the condition of life of the average Nigerian. That is one reason, and that is one factor that has now changed. We have a government in place today that you can trust. Everybody knows that your money is safe in the hands of this government.
Ibrahim Bashir also explained that in 2012, Nigerians made so much money from the sales of crude oil, which it was enough to support subsidy payment.
In 2012, we had some comfort in the amount of foreign reserves that we had that was going to be able to support the subsidy. In 2016, that is not the case. The money we had since then had all been stolen. Nothing was saved. So we had no buffer to support the subsidy as of today. So whether anybody likes it or not, like I said, it is impossible to continue indefinitely to subsidize.
Muyiwa Bamdele reporting.
All Progressive Congress national leader Senator Bola Tinubu has appealed to the leaders of the Nigerian Labour Congress to return to the negotiation table with the federal government to resolve the agitation over new pump price of petrol. Tinubu, who met with the leadership of Ayuba Nwaba-led faction of NLC alongside Osun State Governor Rauf Arebeshola, Senator Marafa, among others, said it's time for the country to move forward, called on the union to call off its strike.
My mission here is for peace. My mission here is for us to return to the negotiating table. In war. What will they end it? They say they go to Geneva, they go to Philippines. Even what is happening in Syria now, they are saying they must come and discuss peace in Geneva, and so on and so forth. After destruction and devastation, they still will end up discussing and having an understanding to build their country back.
He maintained that the decision of federal government to increase fuel price is for the benefit of all Nigerians and also help in opening of a level playing ground for those that are willing to invest in the country.
Let's open the opportunity, level playing ground, for all other investors to bring refinery into this country. If you are under the price control regime, there is no way any investor will come and establish revenue.
In his response, Ayuba Nwaba reiterated Labour's commitment to negotiate with federal government.
We have taken note of the plea that you have made, including this high-level delegation. And I assure you that this will be discussed and communicated to the appropriate organ of NLC. Because as you know, that we are a mass organization, very democratic. And therefore, in most cases, we take decisions from beneath and then the leaders must actually push through it. And I think this opportunity will actually require that we also convey this same information and plea and the delegation and the caliber of delegation that are here to our people.
He added that the labor union under his leadership will continue to dialogue with federal government in the best interest of the working class and Nigerians at large. From Abuja, LM Chukwuemeka report.
The Nigerian Senate says over 162 motions have been read on the floor of the Red Chamber in the last 10 months of the 8th National Assembly. Chairman of Senate Committee on Media and Public Affairs, Senator Sabi Abdullahi, made this know in a chat with journalists in Abuja.
For the records, let me say that as of today, we have over, because I'm not sure we've been able to get the full number. But so far, we have gotten, up to April, nothing less than 162 motions have been read in the floor of the Senate. And these motions, like most of you must have been following, are aimed at addressing certain deficiencies, correcting certain bad practices that we have seen, or bringing to the fore certain issues that ordinarily are left unattended to, or even commiserating with Nigerians on certain unfortunate or sad event that have happened.
The Senate spokesman also disclosed that over 125 petitions have been received and treated by the Senate during the period under review.
That we do, you know, receive petitions through various senators, and on this, there was nothing less than 125 petitions that we have received, bordering on people who have been mostly unjustly terminated or sacked from their jobs. And I will recall one that I brought to the press corps, if you remember, which was sponsored by my good friend, Senator Olamilekan Adeola, having to do with somebody who was dismissed verbally from the police for over 20 years. His family suffered, his children suffered, and in fact, he went through hell. And I think through the instrument of the Senate Committee on Public Petitions, my good friend Senator Anyanwu, that committee was able to get to the bottom of that crisis or that issue, and that injustice was corrected.
Muyiwa Bamdele reporting from Abuja.
Hi, Mike.
Babe, it's been over 12 hours. Are you done thinking about it?
Is the answer yes?
Convince me.
I know how much confidence style means to you. Let me take you somewhere.
Where?
What's that?
A superior leading international hospitality chain in the heart of Africa.
And?
They offer very distinct services. Their meeting halls and all their hotels offer conference solutions that can help plan a perfect function for any occasion. They feature outdoor catering and provide services for any size event.
Keep going. You got me thinking now.
The beauty, the decor, and the views. It's the hotel experience you always dreamed of. They have up-to-date entertainment and a variety served at the fast food restaurant and snack bar. Oh, and don't even get me started on the garden bar or the nightclub. You would have everything you need within your reach without having to go out.
Wow. So what if I want to
cook? They got you, babe. The rooms are thoughtfully furnished with facilities that aid proper cooking, just like you would at home.
Where is this place?
And it's sweet.
Wow.
So, will you marry me?
Yes. How can I refuse?
Not at Sweets, a colorful affair.
A member of House of Representatives, Honorable Garba Shede Amajide from Taraba State, has said the federal legislators will provide framework for the executive arm of government to enhance the welfare package of civil servants in the country. Honorable Amajide stated this while speaking with journalists at National Assembly Complex, Abuja, saying that Nigerian workers need salary raise, to cushion the effect of hike in the pump price of petroleum products.
With this fuel increment, we are going to tell the government to increase the salary so that to meet up. So that is why the House constituted a committee to sit down with the labor to see the way out. Actually, as you have said, things in the market is going to increase. So that's why this committee, which have been constituted by the House, which have been constituted by the Honorable Speaker of the House, to sit down with the labor to see how the salaries are going to increase the workers' salary. And another thing, the main reason why government increased this products, the price of this product, is that the state government, the local governments, they cannot even meet up in paying their salaries.
The House of Representatives member also commended President Muhammadu Buhari-led administration campaign against corruption.
We are getting the change. And also in terms of corruption, you can see this government is fighting this corruption, and it's fighting it in the way of understanding. It's fighting it in the way, not in winch hunting. It's fighting it in the way of there's no any partiality in it. So whoever you are, whether you are a prince, whether you are a poor person, once if you have been found wanting in terms of corruption, the government will apprehend you and take you to the appropriate agency for investigation. So here, too, we can say it, the change is coming.
Muyiwa Bamdele reporting from Abuja. As part of the measures to boost security network in Nigeria, the chairman, Senate Committee on Police Affairs, Senator Abu Ibrahim, has supported the call for the establishment of state police. Senator Abu Ibrahim called on the Nigerian police to kickstart the state police structure with community policing by allowing rank and file of the force to serve in their respective state in order to enhance security operation.
So my view is all policemen, especially rank and file, should remain in their state of origin because they will work better, more effectively, and they have taken a lot of weight out of their heads, because if you take them from Hadejia to Otwaki, the man will go there and become dazed, confused. He doesn't know what to do. He doesn't know where to start. But if you live in Hadejia, well, he can go and eat his burabusko and and they can speak the local language.
Speaking on the ongoing recruitment exercise into the Nigerian police, the chairman said the exercise is on course as expected, saying that each state of the federation have been given equal allocation slot.
So that a number of things are programmed that will eliminate those unwanted, not unwanted or unwanted in court applicants. And now they are doing state by state sorting out. Two, as I have said, states are allocated a certain number for the officers, equal number. And local governments are allocated equal number. The screening will be made at state level to avoid what happened in the immigration. Because now we have every local government has its own number, states have its own number of officers, so it's better to be at the state level. So the computer now will sort out states, local governments.
Over 950,000 Nigerians have so far applied for the 10,000 vacancy slot in the Nigerian police. From Abuja, Muyiwa Bamdele reporting.